Bowers and
Cassandra Fuller.
Welcoming you to Six in the City.
I'm back.
Oh,
did
you're
you
back.
Miss me?
Oh, that's right. Oh, you were gone.
I was
Man,
gone.
I remember that.
You know, I was hoping to do an on-location shoot, but just
oh,
that
from,
fiber just won't cross the ocean.
Won't cross that ocean.
No,
yet,
it did not cross the ocean.
We're going to try to get that done.
But,
well, it is star time today for a couple of reasons.
It
Makayla
is.
Collins is with us.
She
making
is.
Making her first appearance with us. We're delighted to have her here.
Woo-hoo.
And star time at the Apollo, as the announcers you say, Mike Keith, the voice of the Titans,
the voice
is with
of
us.
The Titans. We're so
the
excited
voice.
To have him here in the studio.
And we're delighted to have him with us. And he spent the day with us, and
he
so
has.
It's always a pleasure.
It is.
Look forward to it. And we have some other folks.
We do.
Here.
Beth Kaufman is here because the Jackson Award nominations are still going on. The
That's
deadline's
right.
coming up, July 28th. So she's wanting you to get in those nominations okay. for the Jackson Awards. And then also with RIFA, we have Chelsea Kroon.
That's
because
right,
Canstruction is
we get ready
up.
For Canstruction. That's a big celebration coming up September the 28th. But we're looking for more teams to
more
compete
teams,
in the
that's right.
Canstruction. Amy Morris is with us, the American Cancer Society. We get ready to do Making Strides Against Breast Cancer. That's coming up in October. We got a kickoff
the
breakfast
kickoff?
Coming up in August,
August,
and we'll get details of you on that. And then David Knack is with us from the Star Center. They got a Henry Winkler
Henry
coming to
Winkler.
Town.
Henry Winkler. That should be so interesting.
Should be fun. All right, so all that's coming up. And then Makayla Collins is with us, as we said, and she'll be our star performer today.
That's right.
So it's already
going.
Mike
to
Keith
it.
Is coming up next as we do this
Six in the City. City.
Fiber, it may be small, but it is powerful. It connects our city, businesses, and homes to the world. Without it, our ability to compete economically and enjoy technology would be limited. Thanks to the investment in our city by JEA, we offer the area's first and only 100% fiber network. When you choose E-Plus Broadband, you get the clearest reception, fastest speeds, and greatest reliability. Thank you for choosing E-Plus Broadband and for your trust in the local service we provide right here in Jackson.
First Baptist Church is about making disciples, building community, serving others, equipping families, and above all, glorifying God. We'd love to have you join us, First Baptist Church, for God, His gospel, and His glory.
Thank you for voting us Best Cable Television, Internet, and Home Phone in the Jackson Sun Readers' Choice Awards. You can count on us for excellent values and powerful services. Cable television with TiVo offering access to Netflix, Hulu, Pandora, and more. TV everywhere for watching on the go. Fastest internet speeds in the area. Telephone with features you'll love, all on your JA bill. Thank you for choosing E-Plus Broadband and for your trust in the local service we provide right here in Jackson.
Different ball
game. Oh, we're up. Oh, yeah.
We're just having a conversation amongst ourselves.
We're having a big time here.
Thank you for joining
we're
us.
Talking, Mike Keith is with us, the voice of the Titans. And we're talking about the business side of football, and that's the side we don't see often, but they're talking about going to maybe one day an 18-game season.
Oh, it's been
Jordan,
talked about.
And Jordan, the preseason.
Ownership would like to do that. The commissioner would like to do that. The commissioner's on record as saying he doesn't think the preseason meets the regular season standard of NFL football. And
okay.
I think a lot of people probably agree with that, but there's a dollars and cents part of it because the players, as part of the collective bargaining agreement and the salary cap, they get a certain percentage of ticket revenue. So if they just lopped off two preseason games, that money would just go away, so there would be less money.
Okay.
For the players.
Players, okay.
And when the players begin to understand that, they normally go, hey, wait a minute. Yeah, hang on just a second there. So we'll see.
Does a 16 or 18 game season, I mean, there was a time when every game was like big, big, big. And they because we've had some teams the last couple of games that go, we're in the playoffs, our starters are not playing, we're going to play it safe. I mean, that's a question. But, and I wonder, 18 game season then opens up the potential, I guess, for more of that. Right?
I think the way that you curb as much of that as you possibly can is to go to seven teams in the playoffs, to add a team in each conference,
okay.
because then instead of the top two getting a bye, only one team would
get a
bye.
Okay.
So two would play seven, three
okay.
would play three
okay.
would play six, four would play five, and the top seed would get a bye. I think we will expand our playoffs. There's part of that, though, that's very difficult from the standpoint that if you've had a great year and if you've earned the right to do what you want at the end of the season, how can the league tell a team you have to play your starters? It's
disappointing for the fans.
It's not great for the fans. But we haven't had much of an issue of it as of late.
It seemed to hit that 1 year. Of course, baseball's talking about adding another wild card thing in here. You know,
I love it. Bob Costas doesn't love it.
As fans, you know, but then when you work all in your preseason and season, and then you get in there and somebody could beat you one game and knock you out, you know, and so I know.
Well,
that's baseball.
It's never hurt any sport to expand their postseason. We've never gotten hurt going to 68 teams in the NCAA tournament, 16 in the NHL or the NBA. Mm-hmm. No sport has ever been hurt by expanding their playoffs.
One of these days it'll be like high school. Everybody gets in the district tournament, and here we go.
Well, that's okay. That's fun, too.
That's fun. All right. Well, now, how are we doing this year?
Right now, we're not doing anything. Right now.
So right now, we're Super Bowl
contenders. Right now, we're quiet, which is why I have the chance to be with you guys today. 10 days from now, we report. Okay. And we have our first practice at St. Thomas Sports Park, which is open to the public.
All right.
Okay. At 2:30 on Saturday, July the 29th. And then we will practice again on Sunday, July the 30th at 2:30. And those practices both open to the public. We have 13 of them open to the public. You can read them all at TitansOnline.com. But for folks in the Jackson area, one of those first two practices would be absolutely perfect to get up there and get back and have a chance to see
players
the team work out.
Players sometimes sign autographs and stuff.
They do. We have a set number of players that sign autographs after every public practice.
Okay. All right. So
pictures,
that's
people can get pictures with them?
Oftentimes, if they're agreeable, which they, you know, and in some ways they would almost rather do pictures now because most people request pictures because everybody's got a phone.
Phone, right. Okay.
So a lot of times you get more picture requests and the players are just fine with that. All they have to do is smile.
Just smile. Right.
And the Titans love it, I'm sure, because it gets tweeted and shared. And
we love it. You know, anything at Titans is a great thing. Then we always appreciate people sending things out with us and the players and people out in the community and doing different things. It's really a lot of fun for the entire organization. And those practices are actually being upped in terms of the intensity with which the fans are required to participate because we have brought in more bleachers for them to be able to see the practices better because John Robinson and Mike Mularkey want the fans to be more involved. They're saying, hey, we're going to make you more comfortable, but we need you to yell more.
Okay, so they want
that's all they want.
Okay.
Yell more.
All
yell
they
more.
Want. Now, do you have to pay to come?
Absolutely
so
not.
It's a free thing.
It's free.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Used to, you had to stand.
Yeah.
And now, with the increased bleachers, we're putting in temporary bleachers at St. Thomas Sports Park. Plenty of places to sit, good place to watch. They want more noise, they want more of a feel in that way to not only give the players some crowd noise, but really to help add that enthusiasm during those hot practices.
Okay.
Because you got that crowd pumping you up on those days where you're not playing towards anything that means anything.
That hot, sweaty day.
Right. So that crowd noise really helps a lot.
Mike Keith is with us, and we're talking Titans football. We'll continue this conversation in just a moment on this Six in the City.
In 1986, my life changed forever when I struck three buried high-voltage cables while working on an excavation site. 30,000 volts of electricity blew through my body. I'm lucky to be alive and able to walk again. Today, accidents like mine can be avoided with a simple call to 811 in order to have your dig site marked.
Always call 811 before digging and be a hero. Respect the flags. Brought to you by Tennessee 811.
Drawing from a tremendous underground aquifer, JA's water supply is sand filtered by nature. This water supply is not only plentiful, it requires minimal treatment. Continually lab tested for quality, it's the water distributed through the water division at JA. More than once named by the Tennessee Association of Utility Districts as West Tennessee's best tasting water. Clean water, another part of JEA today.
Hi, I'm Bob.
I'm Bob.
And I'm Bob.
And I'm Cherie with Lifeline Blood Services, and we're here with the Bobs of Bob's House of Honda.
That's right, Cherie. We're concerned for West Tennessee's blood supply, so we're donating a 2017 Ranger 500 to encourage blood donations this summer.
Anyone who gives blood at any blood drive or at the blood center during June or July can register to win this Polaris Ranger 500. Give blood, save lives.
Welcome back to Six of the City. Makayla Collins is with us. We'll hear from her up in just a few minutes. Looking forward to that. Mike Keith, the voice of the Titans, continues to visit with us. And so, all right, we're ready to go. What will happen when they come back? How intense is it? The intensity goes up now?
Fast.
So these...
Very quickly. Okay. They get in on the 28th and the 29th. I guess probably the 29th and the 30th, they won't do pads. And then I would guess on the 31st, he puts them in pads and they...
So we go.
And they go.
Okay.
The only thing that they have that they like now is they have, in the last collective bargaining agreement, the Players Association negotiated a mandatory day off during training camp. And so they get a day off and get a chance to rest and recruit, which is really kind of good for everybody.
Okay. Yeah.
How many people come into camp? Like, how many are allowed?
90 players.
90 players.
Players.
We go to 50.
We'll go to 53, This is the first year that we have not made a cut down before the fourth preseason game to 75 players. So we will cut 37 players essentially Labor Day weekend.
Wow.
So it's on the line for a lot of these guys.
It's totally on the line. Okay. And what's most interesting about our roster this year is last season I sat down and took a magic marker and went through, and I found 31 players that I was sure that were going to be on the roster. Like Marcus Mariota is going to be on the roster. Okay. We know that. Well, I found 30 other guys like Marcus Mariota. This year, my number is over 40.
Oh, wow.
So that shows you it's a better roster. It shows you that the remaining players are going to have to compete harder to get those last 10, 11, 12 spots. That's a very good thing for the Tennessee Titans. That's where you want to be.
Okay. So the core is solid.
The core is very solid.
Okay. So you're encouraged by the moves that were made as far as the draft and people that have been brought up, sharp secondary and some other things.
We got better in the secondary. We got better at the wide receiver position. We added more overall speed to the roster. We've improved our special teams very dramatically. I think there is much reason for optimism based on the overall talent on the roster. It's a much better it's a much better roster than when John Robinson got here 18 months ago. It's a much better roster. Really, since the draft, even you can see the difference in what they've been able to do. And adding Eric Decker at wide receiver in mid-June was a huge acquisition.
John's Western Seaboy, so we're proud
of him.
Yes,
he is.
And so
you know, there are two NFL general managers
from Western Seaboy
from within 20 miles of one another.
Stunning,
one from Lake County and one from Obion County.
It's just amazing.
What are the chances?
There are not that many people in Lake and Obion County to begin with.
And you know what's interesting? They're two of the better general managers in the National Football League.
Well, it's exciting.
Well, good for West Tennessee.
That's it.
it's good to see. You say the first four games of the season are really crucial for this team, just the nature of the schedule and who we're coming up against.
Well, you're playing Oakland to start with. I think Oakland will be one of the picks to go to the Super Bowl by a lot of the national pundits, and with good reason. That on paper, they may have the best team in the AFC overall. They're the home opener. We traveled to Jacksonville in week two. Kind of owe Jacksonville.
Kind of have
that relationship with Jacksonville anyway.
I've seen gesture would be appropriate. We're just not going to do it.
Steve Bowers. Send your letters to Steve Bowers and Cassandra Fuller.
Well,
they kept us out of the playoffs.
We kept
ourselves out of the playoffs.
Well,
really.
We did. But we have that kind of relationship with them. We also kept them out of the Super Bowl 17 years ago. So. We want that in week two. We play down there. We certainly owe them. Seattle in week three, and then at Houston in week four. So four very tough games, three AFC games, two of them within our division. Really important. If we could be 3-1 after those four games, I think you say, man, this could be a special year for the Titans. If we're 4-0, you won't want to be around me. I will be out of control. Okay. I will be a wild man.
Okay. The core in this team is back, and you say, as far as the coaching staff and everybody there.
Yeah. It hasn't happened in nearly 10 years.
Because we went through, after Jeff Fisher left, a complete wipe out of everything.
And every year it seemed like we had various turnovers in personnel, in coaching, in philosophy, and you can't keep doing that. Yeah. We're going to do the same thing on offense. We're going to do the same thing on defense. We have the same offensive and defensive coordinators. As a matter of fact, only one major change in the coaching staff. We brought in a new wide receiver coach. That's the only change. All of the top players, when you look at our charts, are leading this, are leading that, they're all back.
Okay.
And that just has not happened for us, along with the same head coach, Mike Mularkey. So it's a very exciting time because I think for the first time in nearly a decade, we have something to build on.
Okay. So how does that affect the morale of the players?
It's big time. They know each other. Right. The adjustment period is not there. They're going to be able to jump right into training camp. They jumped into the offseason program, Cassandra, just like the 2016 season never ended.
Never ended.
They'll
yeah.
jump right into training camp ready okay. to go, and you can get more done that way.
That's good. Yeah. That maybe the, hopefully good. That keeps yeah. that momentum going, and we can just continue that momentum and just
boom.
Go straight
yeah,
through
go
to the playoffs.
You take it with Titans All Access.
Yeah. Just drop it. Throw it down.
Thomas will yell at me. I can't do that.
Throw it down.
Yeah. Titans All Access so right here at E-Plus TV6, and Mike Nimmer at work already, and so we'll follow that with great interest. Always good to
it
see
you. It is. It's good to have thank you, Mike. Titans. It's always
a pleasure. We
appreciate
it very much.
All right.
We're delighted to have this young lady with us. She's from Jackson, Tennessee, a student at Crockett County High School, and her name is Makayla Collins. Makayla?
And she call me the girl. What you want from me? I tried to buy your pretty heart, but the price too high. Baby, you got me like a fool. You love when I fall apart, so you can pull. Just to get close to you, we'll burn something, babe. And I'll run for miles just to get taste. Must be love on the brain. It's got me feeling this way. It beats me black and blue, but it treats me so good, and I can't get enough. It keeps cursing my name. No matter what I do, I'm no good without you, and I can't get enough. Must be love on the brain. Then keep love me, just love me, yeah. Love me. All you need to do is love me. Just to get close to you, gonna burn something, babe. And I'll run for miles just to get taste. Must be love on the brain. It's got me feeling this way. It beats me black and blue, but it treats me so good, and I can't get enough.
Tim Tebow, two-time collegiate national champion, Heisman Trophy winner, NFL first-round draft pick, professional baseball player, faith-focused philanthropist. Join us when Tim Tebow headlines the 53rd annual Freed Hardeman Benefit Dinner Friday, December 1st. Enjoy a great meal, entertainment, and hear Tebow. Reserve your tickets at fhu.edu. And thank you for making a difference in students' lives. The Freed Hardeman Benefit Dinner, Friday, December 1st.
Yo voy a ganar esta batalla.
Let's go.
It's gone! That's some kind of power. Swing and a miss. What a catch. the ball game is over.
Major League Baseball, all season long on ESPN.
I am Timmy Allgood with the Tennessee Department of Agriculture, inviting you to join us on Saturday, July 22nd at the Toast of Jackson Wine Festival. You'll see over 14 wineries there and 24 local artisans, as well as great local food. So come and join us between 1 and 6 on Saturday, July 22nd. All funds benefit the Jackson Exchange Club.
Purchase advance tickets online at toastofjackson.com or at the Civic Center box office.
Welcome back to Six in the City. We'll have more with Makayla Collins. Good to have her with us.
It was. Very good.
Very good. Beth Kaufman is with us for the foundation. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Well, glad to be back.
You got some breaking issue a few months ago for years with the foundation or something, right? Or,
oh, yeah, 10 years.
10 years with the foundation.
She's like, oh, yeah.
I was like, what did I get recognition for?
Oh, no big deal.
10 years of foundation. 10 years here, 10 years there. Yeah. But anyway, congratulations for the special work that is being done. We're here because the Jackson Awards are coming up later this year with the part of the healthcare gala and all that, but the deadline for nominations is July 28th, so that's approaching.
Yes, just like a week and a half.
A week and a half away, aren't you? We got folks out there, and there are folks that should be recognized and need to be nominated.
Absolutely. I know it's hot, but it's time to think about November. That seems weird, but
we're looking for folks that contribute to this community in the arts, community service, education, healthcare, leadership, and volunteer service. So there are six categories. How do you get an application?
It's all online. So you go to thecharitygala.org/Jackson.
Okay.
But if you make it to thecharitygala.org, you'll be able to find your way around for sure. Okay. And it's just you type in the fields and hit submit, and it sends me an email with all the information. Now, if people want to add additional information, then they are welcome to email that to me as well. I have people that'll do that. Okay. And if multiple people want to get together and nominate someone, then they can all submit that person's name as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So we recommend doing it. thecharitygala.org/Jackson.
That's correct.
Okay. All right. So
You be nominated in more than one category?
Yes. We oftentimes have people that maybe fit leadership, volunteer service, and community service, or somewhere along those lines, and that is fine. The committee looks at that, so oftentimes they'll take that into account if they fit into one category better, or sometimes they fit into multiple categories, and so they'll look at that as they review
those nominations. How did this get started?
It started back in 2006 as a way to recognize servant leaders in our community and people who were doing things that they often maybe not recognized for.
Okay.
And so this will be the 12th year that we've done it.
Okay.
And so we have recognized 64 people because their first 2 years there were just five categories.
Okay.
So we definitely want the community's help in helping us know who hasn't been recognized. And there's a complete list, too, when they go to the website of everybody who's been recognized in the past.
Yes, okay.
So they can look, if they're not sure if they've been recognized before or not, they can look at the list and double check.
Now, the gala itself is coming up when?
Saturday, November the 11th.
November the 11th, which will be here before we know it.
Absolutely. Sponsorships are available.
Beth is like, I'll take your money now.
Give me a call.
Tablecloths and all that stuff.
Email
are tickets
Beth,
on sale
right
now?
Yes, tickets are on sale.
So if I go to the Charity Gala, then...
Yes, you can purchase them on the website, thecharitygala.org. You can call me and make a reservation, and I will be glad to invoice you.
Okay.
And it's going to be
She'll be glad to come pick up your money.
Okay, so we got to...
We've got a theme. Jim Norton is going to be our chair, gala chair again, and we are going to be celebrating Gatsby style.
That should be
very interesting. We've got a great Gatsby theme. And already looking at decor and everything is going to be
so we need to start looking for clothes right now.
Absolutely. People are excited.
I bet so. It's always fun when there's
and
a
looking
theme.
For, that kind of 20, roaring 20s attire. So we think it'll be very fun.
It'll be fun. And so that's what night again? It's November?
November the 11th.
November the 11th.
Of course, the patient's party will be the night before on the team.
So it's Veterans Day.
So November 11th is Saturday, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Saturday, yeah. Because we have Veterans Parade that day.
That's right.
Veterans Day.
That is right. Yeah, we always kind of are close to Veterans Day.
Yeah, close to Veterans Day, but this year falls on Saturday. So now we know thecharitygala.org.
Get
so we can
your
get tickets.
Award nominations
get tickets,
in.
Tickets. You can nominate somebody.
Someone.
You can see all the past recipients and read their bios.
Well, there's a ton of work that goes into this.
There is.
I went down there for a little while last year, and I realized I was out of place.
I was going to say, did they kick you out because you were just down there?
And you want to, you know, but then
I know that's my point.
There's certain
ways
you fold
there.
Things and unfold things, all of a sudden, I realized I was out of my league.
Yeah, because they were working.
It takes lots of volunteers. We actually produced a video last year about the gala, which is on our Facebook page.
Okay.
That gives you a little bit behind the scenes look of how all that comes together.
Well, it's the awesome. Elegant night in our city.
It is. And what's the Facebook page? Is it
West Tennessee Healthcare Foundation?
Okay, West Tennessee Healthcare Foundation on Facebook.
Well, those nominees, should be recognized, and that is due Friday, July 28th. So get that taken care of. thecharitygala.org/Jackson. There.
Absolutely. If anybody has any questions, they can give me a call at the foundation. 984-2144.
984-2144. It's always good to see you.
It is.
Thank you for having me.
It's always yours.
Yes, congratulations on your 10 years.
10 years. Yeah. Let's go back to the main stage. We welcome once again Makayla Collins. Makayla.
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case, I could offer you warm embrace to make you feel my shadows and the stars appear, and there's no one there to dry your tears. I could hold you for a million years to make you feel my love. I know you haven't made your mind to be. Do you wrong? I know that from the moment that we met, no doubt in my mind where you belong. I go hungry, I go black and blue, I go crawling down the avenue.
Service is not just what we say, it's what we do. When you choose E-Plus Broadband for your cable, internet, and telephone services, you can trust us to provide unmatched reliability. From sales to installation, we work hard to bring the services you depend on every day. We're currently upgrading the network to increase our service offerings available to you. So look for us in your neighborhood soon. And thank you for choosing E-Plus Broadband and for your trust in the local service we provide right here in Jackson.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson of the Tennessee Highway Patrol. Over my career, I've been asked, what's the most difficult part about being a state trooper? That's easy. The hardest part about being a state trooper is going to someone's house and telling the people there that someone they love is never, ever coming home because of a senseless, preventable traffic crash. In Tennessee, every year, way too many lives are lost by drinking and driving, texting and driving, and not wearing your seatbelt. Please don't make me tell your loved ones that you're not coming home.
With E-Plus Broadband and Watch TV Everywhere, you can now take your TV on the go. Just visit WatchTVEverywhere.com to sign up. Then you're all set to catch your favorite shows, movies, and sports wherever and whenever you want on any internet-connected device. Choose from our growing selection of networks from your cable package at no extra charge. Visit WatchTVEverywhere.com to learn more. It's easy to sign up for E-Plus Broadband's TV Everywhere.
Well, you open the door and you never know who's going to walk in.
That's exactly right. But surprise.
Surprise. Lindsay Dawkins is with us with Rifa.
Good to be here.
So you're back.
Yes.
Okay.
I am back with Rifa.
With Rifa. All right. So where you need to be, I guess.
I know.
Okay.
I think it's where God has laid on my heart to be.
Well, that's good. Well, there are all kinds of reasons for that because of the wonderful work that they do with the Regional Interfaith Association. We have a big event coming up in September. It's Canstruction September the 28th. Couple of things we need to do. One thing, we still have openings for teams.
We do.
We want to have 18.
Capacity is 18.
Because they've gone to the Civic Center, so we've got a little more build-out room there.
That's right. And so, like Cassandra said, we're at 14 right now. Uh-huh. So we have four more spots open. And it's some tough competition. Everyone is out to beat Toyota Bodine this year. So everyone needs to sign up.
We're very glad Toyota Bodine is in the city and with us.
We are.
We're just sick and tired of them winning.
That's right. So we're going to do hashtag beat Bodine.
That's right. I've heard of rumors of shirts being made.
That's right. I don't know where you heard that from, but hashtag Bodine.
Some little gremlin that may sneak into the Civic Center and tear down somebody's construction.
We wouldn't go, I don't think anybody would go that far.
I know. We're not like a professional wrestler. We're not going to pull
That's
hair.
Right. We're not hair pullers.
But the teams are very vital to the construction. Yeah. I mean, that's what it's all about, is these teams building these giant structures.
Yeah. And build-out starts when?
The build-out is the 26th, so that Tuesday.
September 26th
is the build-out. And so
still plenty of time actually, to get your team, buy your cans, and get your sculpture
You
done.
Can actually then see the, if people want to come and see these structures, and they're magnificent.
They are
incredible. What you can create a piece of sculpture out of canned goods.
And we're talking 10 foot by 10 foot. Mm-hmm. It's not a little box. Like, I would build a little Rubik's Cube. Right. That's what mine would be.
But
nothing wrong with that, because the food goes to Rifa.
But you can see those like the 27th?
Yes, so when the Civic Center is open, so the 27th, 28th, and 29th, and even that Saturday, you can stop by and see the structures, because they will tear them down the following Monday.
This is a international design competition, too. So, I mean, this is...
That's right. This is big.
Teams can advance and whatever. We've had some really good stuff.
It's just a fun event. Construction, like you said, it's meant for teams. They build these structures completely out of canned foods. Mm-hmm. And then all that food goes back to Rifa and distributed throughout our ministries.
Now, a few years ago, when we had the 10th anniversary, we started doing a big gala-type evening. We got a special artist that's coming in.
That's right. We're excited to announce that Natalie Grant will be our performer this year. And we've had, the last couple of years have been great with Stephen Curtis Chapman and Michael W. Smith. And so we're excited for Natalie Grant. We decided we had changed it up and add a female vocalist this year. Okay. And so she is a 6-time Grammy nominated artist. The Gospel Music Association has named her Female Vocalist of the Year 5 times. And she's been compared to Celine Dion. So we're excited
kind of
to have
deal.
Her. Yes. when you get in the category with Celine Dion,
that's right.
I feel like you've done well for yourself.
Exactly.
So Natalie Grant will be here. That'll be the 20th. The evening will start at what time?
The evening will start at 6.
6, okay.
And we will have, for the people who buy a table or an individual table ticket, we'll have dinner. And Old Country Store will be doing our catering again this year.
Fine.
They've done great the last couple of years. And so we have table tickets, which is a table eight seats, and that is $750. Okay. And then if you just want, you and your husband or wife at, two, you can buy individual tickets for $100 each.
And that's individual table tickets.
Table tickets, yes. And then we also have, say you don't want to go to
dinner,
we have balcony tickets for $15 each. So you can bring your whole family. You can bring your youth group.
Okay.
So they're really reasonable.
You can hear Natalie then at night.
That's correct.
All right. So what time will the concert start then?
The concert will start around 7:30
or so. Okay.
Because we do have an awards program. The whole idea of moving it into a gala form is to give a lot of recognition to the teams. And so this is an award ceremony for them as well.
To get those tickets, it's 427-7963, 427-7963.
Can you get tickets online,
They
too?
Can. Visit our website at rifajackson.org, and that is usually the easiest way to get them.
Okay.
But you can call us.
Or stop by the Rifa.
Or stop by. Okay. All of those forms, we will get you tickets.
All right.
If we stop by, and if it's somebody that hadn't seen the facility, you can give them a tour, right?
That's right. Yeah. So we love giving tours.
Thrift store and all that stuff. Thrift store's open what hours now?
We have summer hours, so it's Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m.
9 to 6, okay.
So it's a great place to shop and everything.
Yes,
all the money
lots
goes
of good finds.
And then also you can clear out your closet and make donations.
That's right.
Take them down to Rifa.
That's right.
It's a win. The money stays here locally.
It is a
community.
Win-win. Yeah. You get rid of it, we get to use it, and then the profits go back into our ministries.
That's wonderful.
It's good to see you. Glad you're back.
It's good to have you.
Thanks.
I know Rifa's glad to have you back.
Congratulations. Congratulations to Rifa. And we'll see you on the 28th for this year's Can Structure.
Go ahead and get your tickets.
We're back with more as we continue Six in the City.
JA Site Pay Kiosk are the convenient way to pay your utility bill. These kiosks are featured in the foyer at Martin Luther King Jr. Drive, and at the drive-thru at Pleasant Plains Extended. Use your account number and follow step-by-step prompts to pay with cash, check, credit, or debit card. Account credit is immediate, and a printed confirmation receipt is provided. Another step in customer service at JEA today.
Ready, set, go for it. It's your adventure. This is your GAC.
Steve Beverly's TV classics can cure what ails you.
I watched and it got rid of my hemorrhoids.
Staying awake at night? Just watch TV classics.
My daughter watched and she went right to sleep.
Do not watch Steve Beverly's TV classics. It bites, upsets your stomach. Do not watch if high drama leads to emotional distress. And do not turn on TV 6 Saturday or Sunday at 7 if hillbillies give you a gallbladder attack.
Ask your doctor if Steve Beverly's classics is right for you.
Welcome back to Six of the City. Makayla Collins is with us, and we'll hear more from her. She's
so
an outstanding vocalist.
She is. It's been wonderful.
Delighted to have her with us today. Right now, we're talking to Amy Morris, and we're getting ready. Well, we got Making Strides Against Breast Cancer coming up October the 21st.
Right. But
a lot of activities going on, but we're going to get ready to launch that August
right.
the 8th.
That's correct.
All right.
So what's
happening August the 8th now?
Well, we always have a kickoff every year to just get everybody excited, motivated to start. You know, Making Strides, we don't do that all year. We just concentrate on Breast Cancer Month of October. So we try to get people, especially new people that maybe don't really understand what the walk is about. We invite them to a kickoff in August, tell them all about it, get everybody fired up, and then it's just short and sweet.
And this is open to anybody who's interested, or
anybody.
survivors can,
yes, we
can
would
attend.
Love to have any survivors in West Tennessee to come so that we can honor them, celebrate them. Our walk here in Jackson is our West Tennessee walk, so we're the only walk that happens for breast cancer between Memphis and Nashville. We had about 2,000 people there last year.
Wow.
So it's hugely popular.
So as many or more.
Yeah,
that's
the kickoff
correct.
Luncheon is coming up Tuesday, August the 8th. It's going to be at Inglewood Baptist Church in the Jet Fellowship Hall from 11 until 12:30.
You don't need tickets, but you need to RSVP because there will be food, and so they need to call to RSVP?
That's correct. If they could just call me, that would be great.
And your number?
731-512-5008.
5008.
Yes. So what happens at the luncheon then? We get there at 11 o'clock.
We start opening up the food lines about 11 o'clock so people can come in and start registering about 11, and then we'll have different booths set up with different things to just learn, and they can get their food and sit down and have a table, and then we just generally have an MC, one of your friends, Christy Turnbow, will be there. You know, Christy's everywhere, so she'll be there again. She was our MC last year, and we'll hear from some breast cancer survivors. We honor our survivors that are in the room, and we talk about advocacy. We also talk about what we can do in Nashville to help with cancer laws that are around.
Okay.
Yes. So
lots and lots of helpful information.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yes. So just, you know, wear your pink.
Attend.
That's right. Attend.
You start advanced fundraising then as you get ready to go into October?
Well, that's what we try to do. Some people are just individual walkers. Some are survivor walkers. And then there's some teams. Mm-hmm. And so if they're going to have a team and they're wanting to do fundraising, they can just pick up materials, learn how to do it. You know, a lot of people are Relay for Life participants, which is also something that I handle in Madison County. But it's different from that. You know, those are teams that are really working hard mm-hmm. and all year. This
all
is
the year. Yeah.
I call this like a grassroots effort. We take a whole lot of people that are willing to just do a little bit and make a big difference.
Okay. That's great. Right.
Making Strides Against Breast Cancer coming up in October.
It's a kickoff luncheon.
But the kickoff luncheon, what we're talking about today, coming up Tuesday, August the 8th, that's right around the corner.
It is right around the corner. Sadly, it's right around the corner.
Yes.
Not for the event, but for the whole year.
No ticket required, but do call Amy. Cool. Let her know that you want to be there that day at Inglewood Baptist Church, 512-5008, 512-5008. So we're just going to try to get everybody motivated, focused, and let's go.
And then thank you so much.
Okay, well, it's a great, great day. That kickoff lunch is coming up Tuesday, August 8th, so let's get ready for that.
That's it.
Wear
your pink.
Making Strides. Now, Making Strides this year is going to be back at the ballpark?
Back at the ballpark. Okay. That's right.
It's been a good venue. And I mean, you can handle a lot of people out there.
That's right. It's
great
a
parking.
Lot of room
yeah.
out there. A
Lots
lot of parking.
Room.
You don't have to worry about where you're going to, you know, get to try to find the event. It's all right there.
And part of the purpose of this, like I said, to recognize also, help motivate people that are going through this and mix with people that have survived this or going through different stages of all this. Yeah. And so it's a great gathering.
Just looked up some statistics. You know that 1 in 8 women will face a breast cancer diagnosis in their lifetime.
Wow.
That's a lot. 1 in 8.
Lot.
252,000 women will die from breast cancer this year. In 2017.
Just this year alone.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
That's staggering.
Yes. So, and I may have said that wrong, 252,000 people will have breast cancer, and 40,000 people will pass away this year.
That's still a staggering number.
Yeah, it is.
It's like hard to wrap your head around. You know,
oh my.
Personally, my mom is a breast cancer survivor for years, but her sister, her aunt, they didn't make it. I mean, it's personal for us.
Almost everybody has been touched in some form, some way with cancer. So
that's why 2,000 people show up.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's right.
And we need 2,000 and plus.
August the 8th is the date, and we'll see you there.
The kickoff luncheon.
It's good to see you.
Thank you so much for having me back.
512-5008 is that number. We'll see you on August the 8th. We're going back to the main stage. We welcome once again the talent of Makayla Collins.
Just yesterday morning, let me know you were gone. Susan, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. Jesus, you gotta help me make a step. You just gotta see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it in any other way. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Time on the
Internet security is a big topic in news today. Our concern, our fear, is that our most sensitive information might become available to others. As your local broadband service provider, JA wants to assure you, you can trust us. We have policies in place to protect your privacy. Our goal is to be the most knowledgeable, highly skilled, customer-focused workforce available. Thank you for choosing E-Plus Broadband and for your trust in the local service we provide right here in Jackson.
Hi, I'm Bob.
I'm Bob.
And I'm Bob.
And I'm Cherie with Lifeline Blood Services, and we're here with the Bobs of Bob's House of Honda.
That's right, Cherie. We're concerned for West Tennessee's blood supply, so we're donating a 2017 Ranger 500 to encourage blood donations this summer.
Anyone who gives blood at any blood drive or at the blood center during June or July can register to win this Polaris Ranger 500. Give blood, save lives.
Service is not just what we say, it's what we do. When you choose E-Plus Broadband for your cable, internet, and telephone services, you can trust us to provide unmatched reliability. From sales to installation, we work hard to bring the services you depend on every day. We're currently upgrading the network to increase our service offerings available to you. So look for us in your neighborhood soon. And thank you for choosing E-Plus Broadband and for your trust in the local service we provide right here in Jackson.
Welcome back to Six in the City. We'll have more with Makayla Collins.
She's
very good.
She is. She has
We're delighted to have
voice.
Her with us. David Nack is with us with the Star Center. As if there weren't enough events going on in our city, David said we're going to add one more. How are you doing?
That's right. I'm doing well. Thanks so much for having
us.
He's
closing the nonprofit parade
and
today.
Ours is the soonest. And so
of the events.
Go to all of them, but go to ours first.
That's right.
And if you happen to run out of money along the way, you took care of the first one.
That's right.
We have a party every week or two. Well, every week, two or three times a week in the city,
right.
But it's always for a good cause. And so we have Henry Winkler coming to town.
Henry Winkler,
yeah.
Is most famous for his role as the Fonz. What many people don't know about Henry Winkler is he didn't read his first book till he was 31. So struggled with dyslexia for his entire life.
Okay.
And so when we heard about that, we realized this is the perfect kind of connection for the Star Center.
Okay.
Our mission is to help any person with any disability realize their potential. And one of the main ways we do that is through our literacy lab. It was one of the first services we started. Yeah. We work with folks with or without a disability diagnosis, but we see a lot of people with dyslexia. And once they learn the mechanics, once they learn techniques to overcome that disability, their potential in life is really great.
Okay.
They're able to achieve awesome things because they're able to get that help early on.
Okay. So he was a perfect fit for this event. This is the first
Absolutely.
Time to do one at the Civic Center for the Star
That's
Center.
Right. We're
stepping out here.
30. This year we're coming up to our 30th anniversary.
Okay.
Never done an event in the Civic Center before, and so we're really excited about this. We've been selling a lot of tables, a lot of individual tickets, and so those are going quickly. So get them while you can. Star-center.org.
Tables are how much?
Tables are $1,000 for sponsorship. That includes dinner and drinks for 8 folks. Individual table seats are $100, and balcony seats are $50.
Star-center.org.
That's the one.
Okay. And you can also talk to David at 554-5173 if you want to get
That's
more.
That's right. If you want to buy a table or if you want to spend more money, we'll do it.
Yeah, you can give more than just $1,000.
554-5173 is the number. Yeah, for $2,500, there's a VIP reception included.
Oh, wow.
So table for 8.
Okay.
You can meet Fonz
and
take a picture.
And pictures.
Exactly.
His jacket's in the Smithsonian, and so I mean.
That's right.
He's big time.
He has not been to Jackson, you say, or to West Tennessee?
He has not been to West Tennessee before, to my knowledge. knowledge. He may have made it to Memphis, but this is a once-in-a-lifetime kind of opportunity in West Tennessee to see him, to meet him, and to hear his story.
Okay. So is that what he will do?
He talks about he's the son of German immigrant parents, and he talks about how he grew up, and they thought he was lazy, and they thought he was stupid because, you know, I mean, in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, nobody knew what to do with dyslexia. Yeah. And so he talks about growing up thinking he was stupid, but he graduated high school, college, and then did a master's at Yale in acting, all without any kind of functional literacy skills. And so clearly just a brilliant individual, but someone who throughout their childhood didn't hear that, didn't hear you're good at things. And so now he's turned into the person who goes to schools and says, just because you learn differently doesn't mean you're stupid. Okay. Just because you have challenges that are different than other people doesn't mean that you're not going to amount to anything. Okay. And so that kind of message is something that I think is important for all of us to hear, but especially for people who are like the clients we see every day, who struggle with things that often come naturally to you or I.
I read something somewhere because of his dyslexia that he, you know, obviously had a hard time reading his script, so a lot of his work was ad-lib.
Yeah, when he would audition, he'd memorize as much as he could of the script, and he'd go in there and he'd ad-lib it and say, I'll do it verbatim if you give me the part, but this is what I can do right now. And, you know, I mean, clearly got a lot of parts. You know, he turned down the role of John Travolta's role in Grease.
Oh, wow.
He didn't want to get typecasted. And somebody asked him about it, and he's like, it means I was stupid. I was young and dumb.
Young and dumb. I don't
Travolta
know.
Travolta obviously was able to escape that and go on to many other things,
clearly,
right?
Yeah. Well, and he's escaped the typecast of Fonzie as well and gone on. Clearly, I'm very young. Yeah. If you're listening to this on the radio by some way, I'm a very young person.
Yeah.
And so I know him from Arrested Development and from Parks and Rec.
Okay. He's on Royal Pains.
He's played all these brilliant supporting roles. He's directed, he's produced. And you know what I learned is in looking at Henry Winkler's story of dyslexia, Steven Spielberg has struggled with dyslexia.
He did.
Jennifer Aniston has dyslexia. And so all these people who are just unbelievably creative because their brain is wired in such a way that they have to access that creativity to do the same stuff.
So he goes all the way through Yale. Gets a graduate degree and is not able to read.
That's it.
Struggles.
Yeah, he was in a parent-teacher conference, and one of his children had dyslexia, and the teacher was saying, here's the symptoms. I think your son has dyslexia. And he says, I think I have that. And so now it's gone on. He's written over 30 books with the help of a writing partner. They've been turned into a TV show in the UK. Okay. And so it's just turned into an advocate for education that works for everyone.
Well, Henry Winkler is coming to Jackson, Tennessee. He will be here August the 26th.
Do not miss this opportunity.
At the Carl Perkins Civic Center, 554-5173 or star-center.org. Get those tickets in the balcony for as low as $25.
That's right. And we're already selling a lot of those. People are really excited
about him coming. All right, hearing that story. So it'll
That's
be great.
Awesome.
Davis, good to see you.
It is.
Thanks
good
so
to
much.
Have
Appreciate
you.
It
Look
much.
Forward
good
to
have
this.
You. Continued best with the Star Center, an amazing organization in this community. We'll be back with more as we continue Six in the City.
Stop and think about your health. Don't smoke. If you do, quit. Eat healthy. Make small changes in your diet that can impact your health. Be more active. Start in small ways and keep going. And know your numbers. Your blood pressure and your cholesterol are important to your health.
Friends of Heart ask you be a friend of your own heart.
Jackson 24/7 continues this summer as your source for perspective on people, issues, and key decisions facing our community. Whether it's the economic challenges facing public education, the battle in the streets for local law enforcement, or a bold new leader for higher education. Jackson 24/7 brings you the key questions and answers every day at noon, 4, 6:30, and 9:30 on E+ TV 6.
Hi, I'm Timmy Allgood with the Tennessee Department of Agriculture, inviting you to join us on Saturday, July 22nd at the Toast of Jackson Wine Festival. You'll see over 14 wineries there and 24 local artisans, as well as great local food. So come and join us between 1 and 6 on Saturday, July 22nd. All funds benefit the Jackson Exchange Club.
Purchase advance tickets online at toastofjackson.com or at the Civic Center box office.
Thank you. Well, one thing this hot weather has done is cut out all these 10K marathon running weekends, hasn't it?
I don't have any to talk about. Yeah. I know you're just torn.
Yeah, you have to live like the rest of us. Stay home.
Still have to get out and run. But
we have some special events coming
up. We do. Just this week, Thursday night, it is the Dream Center's fundraiser. It's called That's Amore. It's an Italian dinner. You can get tickets for $30 or a table of 8 for $200. The event is from 6 to 8:30, and it for tickets, you can call 613-0741. I think they've got a Facebook page as well. You can find out all the information. So we need to support the Dream Center. Okay. And then also, Hands Up Preschool is getting geared up for the new school year. They're looking for donations, school products, pencils, pens,
paper supplies,
and things like that.
Or donations.
So if you'd like, or donations, monetary, they're open Monday through Friday from 9 to 3. If you want to, if you have questions, if you want to find out what they need, if you have stuff in your house that you need to get rid of, they will be glad to take it off your hands. 300-4263 is their number.
You get a couple of my events in. Browns Community Rear Tan having their big antique tractor show, but it starts with a pancake breakfast.
Oh, see,
Saturday
there's
morning,
food.
Saturday
it's either
at 7
running
o'clock.
Or food. And
that's
we've
right.
got, we've
and
got.
And then the antique tractors all day, and they have lunch as well. That's out at Browns Community Rear Tan, Browns Community Church Road out there. You know what they're talking about. And the Toast of Jackson.
The Toast, that's right.
That's
it is
the,
coming.
With the
I can't
Exchange
believe it's
Club
time
from
already.
1 to 6 this coming Saturday afternoon at Fairgrounds. We have wineries from all over Tennessee.
From great, East Tennessee to West Tennessee.
Big fundraiser for the Exchange Club, and that's a great event here
it
in
Jackson,
Tennessee.
It is a great event. Tennessee. It's inside, in the air conditioning.
In the air conditioning. It
so
sure
it's
is.
It's a great place to be.
In contrast, a lot of those wine tastings they do outside,
that's
and
right.
so this is nice. This young lady's been a delight to have her with us, Makayla Collins. You can find her on Reverb Nation.
Right.
She'll also be appearing at Music on the Square in Bolivar, Tennessee, Friday night, the 28th of this month at 7 p.m.
She plays different venues around town, so be on the lookout for her.
Be looking for her. She's an outstanding vocalist. We've been delighted to have her with us.
It's been a pleasure to have you.
All right, so we're going to let her close out the show. This is Makayla Collins. Good Lord willing, we'll see you next week with more Six in the City.
Maybe I came on too strong. Maybe I waited too long. Maybe I played my cards wrong. Oh, just a little bit wrong. Maybe I apologize for it. I could fall or I could fly. Even your aeroplane, I could live, I could die. Hanging on the words you say. I've been known to give my all and jump in. So don't call me baby if you don't believe it. And don't tell me you need me if you don't believe it. So let me know the truth before I dive right into you. You're a mystery. I've traveled the like you, no one. What's a history? Do you have a tendency to leave some people alone? Cause I heard you do. I could fall, I could fly, even your aeroplane. I could live, I could die, hanging on the words you say. I've been known to give my all when lie awake. Every day, don't know how much I can take. So don't. Say, I've been known to give my all, sit back, looking at